TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 3rd of April. Prime Minister Narendra Modi asked Indians to light up to fight darkness of coronavirus. NATO chief welcomes US Taliban agreement, says will maintain presence in Afghanistan. And Indian police use innovative ways to raise coronavirus awareness during lockdown. And now for all the details. India's COVID-19 count continued to rise sharply on Friday. Over 100 new coronavirus cases were reported across the country in the last 24 hours, taking the total number of cases in India to over 2,300. Total 56 people have lost their lives due to the pandemic.
COVID-19 count in India climbed to over 2,300 with 56 deaths on Friday. With the rising spread of the pandemic in the country, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in a video address on Friday, appealed countrymen to light candles, lamps, torches and mobile phone flashlights on the evening of 5th of April. He said the event will display India's collective strength in the fight against coronavirus once again, as they did on March 22nd during a voluntary curfew. Prime Minister Modi imposed a nationwide lockdown on March 24 for 3 weeks to mitigate the virus spread in India.
चारों तरफ जब हर व्यक्ति एक-एक दिया जलाएगा, तब प्रकाश की उस महाशक्ति का एहसास होगा, जिसमें एक ही मकसद से हम सब लड़ रहे हैं, ये उजागर होगा। उस प्रकाश में, उस रोशनी में, उस उजाले में, हम अपने मन में ये संकल्प करें कि हम अकेले नहीं हैं।
Most of the fresh coronavirus cases in India, including deaths in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Telangana provinces, are linked to the religious congregation Tablighi Jamaat event held in capital New Delhi's Nizamuddin area last month. Authorities had found and quarantined 9,000 people connected to Delhi event or their close contacts as of Thursday, and are looking for more, India's Interior Ministry said. Also, as many as 960 foreigners have been blacklisted and their tourist visas have been cancelled in connection with the Tablighi Jamaat event.
NATO chief Jens Stoltenberg has reassured support to Afghanistan, saying the alliance will maintain its presence in the country during ongoing intra-Afghan negotiations until stability comes in the country.
NATO allies have welcomed the recently signed peace deal between the United States and the Taliban, and the alliance remains committed to Afghanistan and will maintain its presence in the country during ongoing intra-Afghan negotiations, Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has said. Stoltenberg, while addressing a virtual press briefing on Thursday, said, NATO's aim in Afghanistan was to create the conditions for lasting peace and stability in the country, and it will continue to train, assist and advise the Afghan forces and provide them funds till the stability comes. NATO's reassurance comes as the United States has cut $1 billion from its aid to Afghanistan.
So we have to see progress. We have to see that Taliban is delivering. We have to see progress in the inter-Afghan negotiations to then gradually reduce our presence. It is conditions-based.
Peace deal signed between the United States and the Taliban on February 29 stated that talks between the Taliban and Afghan government would begin on March 10, although this deadline has passed due to the country's political crisis and both sides disagreeing on the release of Taliban prisoners. Earlier on Thursday, the delegations of the Afghan government and the Taliban exchanged lists of prisoners who will be returned to their respective sides, paving the way for the beginning of talks.
Top U.S. diplomat for South Asia, Alice Wells, has condemned a Pakistani court's overturning of a death sentence handed down over the 2002 gruesome killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl. She called the decision an affront.
The United States has criticized a Pakistani court's overturning of a death sentence handed down over the 2002 gruesome killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl, calling the decision an affront. The Sindh High Court in Pakistan's Karachi city on Thursday commuted the death sentence of Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh, the main person accused of kidnapping and murdering Pearl, a Wall Street Journal reporter investigating Islamist militants after the September 11 attacks. Top U.S. diplomat for South Asia, Alice Wells, said on Twitter that the overturning of the convictions for Daniel Pearl's murder is an affront to victims of terrorism everywhere. She said those responsible for Daniel's heinous kidnapping and murder must face the full measure of justice. The court ruled Sheikh's role in the murder wasn't proven and gave him 7 years for the kidnapping. Since he has already spent 18 years in jail awaiting the outcome of an appeal, he's likely to walk free in the coming days. The court also acquitted 3 co-accused.
Moving on, doctors in Pakistan administered Kashmir held a protest recently demanding testing kits and safety gear to deal with coronavirus patients in the illegally occupied region. They blamed Pakistan for a stepmotherly treatment while highlighting the absence of medical facilities in case of a crisis.
The Young Doctors Association or YDA recently held a protest against the Pakistani government demanding safety kits for healthcare staff dealing with suspected coronavirus patients in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. They also raised concerns over no testing kits, mask shortage, no ventilation support and lack of proper isolation wards. They claimed the government has completely failed to provide these basic requirements in the illegally occupied region to deal with the crisis. The protesters also voiced their concern about their salaries, which they said are not at par with doctors in other parts of Pakistan.
Pehli demand corona ke khilaf kits, dusri demand hamari tanhaein, hamare marad Punjab aur federal ke mutabik masavi kiye jaye, ki barabar kiye jaye. Sirf isi surat mein YDA apna kaam continue rakh sakti hai.
The protesting doctors warned that they will be forced to launch a complete strike and withdraw from their elective services if their demands are not met immediately.
आप क्यों एहतजाज कर रहे हो? ये आवाम को जानना ये बात जरूरी है कि स्टेप 1 से लेके जहां पे आपकी कोरोना वायरस की स्क्रीनिंग है, आपके पास यहां पे स्क्रीनिंग किट ही नहीं है, टेस्ट ही नहीं है. तो आपके पास पेशेंट आता है, आप उसको बस क्लिनिकल सस्पिशन पर डायग्नोस करते हो और ज्यादातर को ये रिजेक्ट कर रहे हैं. हुकूमत आवाम को ये धोखा देना चाह रही है कि आपके पास कोई पेशेंट बर्डन ही नहीं है, लेकिन कोरोना वायरस.
Absence of medical facilities has remained a matter of grave concern since long in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. The doctors blamed stepmotherly treatment to the illegally occupied region by Islamabad as the primary cause of their misery.
Sri Lanka has reported its 4th death due to the novel coronavirus. Health authorities confirmed on Friday there are a total 151 positive cases in the island nation so far.
Sri Lanka reported its 4th coronavirus death on Thursday. Director General of Health Services Dr. Anil Jasinghe confirmed the deceased, a 58-year-old male patient, died of worsening of pneumonia from the infection. The patient was receiving treatment at the National Infectious Disease Hospital on the outskirts of capital Colombo. According to the Health Promotion Bureau update released on Friday, a total of 151 cases have been confirmed positive for the COVID-19 in Sri Lanka. While 125 are active cases currently under treatment, 250 suspected cases are under observation. Meanwhile, the island nation continues to remain under curfew and a restriction remains imposed on foreign arrivals. In order to prevent public movements, the country has come up with home deliveries of essentials to households.
Nepal government on Thursday confirmed that one more person has tested positive for COVID-19, making it the 6th case of coronavirus infection in the Himalayan nation. However, one among these who had contracted the disease in January has already recovered.
One more person has tested positive for COVID-19, making it the 6th case of coronavirus infection in the Himalayan nation, Nepal's health ministry confirmed on Thursday. Five of these are active cases, as one person who had contracted the disease in January has already recovered. Nepal Health Ministry spokesperson Bikas Devkota at a press briefing said the sixth case was confirmed during the test at the National Public Health Laboratory on Thursday. The infected person had arrived to Nepal from Doha on March 17. It is the same plane which was shared by the third and fifth persons infected with novel coronavirus. All the six cases reported in Nepal are imported ones.
राष्ट्रिय जनस्वास्थ्य प्रयोगशालामा आज गरिएको परीक्षणमा एउटा पोजिटिभ आएको छ यो अब नेपालमा छैठौं केस पोजिटिभ भयो
Meanwhile, Nepal government has enforced nationwide lockdown on travels from air and grounds, closing borders with both China and India, and closing most of the industries and shops, except those related to essential goods, in order to prevent the spread of COVID-19. The lockdown will last until April 7.
Bangladesh is on a nationwide lockdown until April 9th to contain the spread of coronavirus that has claimed six lives in the country. Amid the virus lockdown, Bangladesh's poor have been most affected ones as they struggle to survive.
Bangladesh has so far recorded six deaths from COVID-19 pandemic, while the number of positive cases has risen to more than 50 as of Friday. The country is under a lockdown until April 9 to contain the spread of coronavirus that has wreaked havoc across the globe, affecting more than 1 million people. Amid the virus lockdown, hungry and desperate rickshaw pullers in Bangladesh had their vehicle confiscated by police on Thursday after they ventured out into capital Dhaka hoping to earn some money. Elsewhere in Dhaka, long queues were seen forming at the ATM, which was still operating after the banks were closed. Long lines of people were also waiting for a food truck which came by to distribute free food and face masks for many of the city's poor, whose numbers are increasing rapidly as they cannot find work.
Most of the bank Dhaka shohore bondho gota koyekta ATM booth khola ei jonno ekhane taka joma dite aschi.
Meanwhile, Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina issued the 31-point directive on Thursday night in view of the COVID-19 outbreak. She urged the people to visit physicians if they experience any symptoms of coronavirus and not to pay heed to any rumor about the virus.
Police force, health workers and all other essential service workers are risking their lives to help India fight the deadly epidemic amid rising coronavirus cases. Security personnel across India have found new ways to generate awareness about the deadly virus and are encouraging people to stay at home during the lockdown.
Amid nationwide lockdown in India to contain the spread of COVID-19 cases, traffic police in southern Bangalore city don spiky headwear representing coronavirus and perform skits to generate awareness about the deadly virus. Police clad in corona helmet raise awareness about the virus using humor rather than force to encourage commuters to stay at home during the lockdown. In southern Chennai city, police ran an awareness campaign on the pandemic coronavirus in the busiest and crowded marketplace of the city. A policeman insisted people not to come out unnecessarily and stay at home while requesting people to maintain social distance.
What we do is we take this near to the public and say that you need to maintain a 1 meter of distance, that social distance. If you maintain this 1 meter of social distance, you can be safeguarded.
For those who violated the lockdown, Chennai city police punished by making them to do sit-ups and warning them not to step out from their houses unnecessarily. Police in southern Kurnool city hired an artist to enact Hindu god of death, Yamraj, in a bid to spread the message of staying indoors.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend and good night.